Welcome back. Just waiting for that. This is the RPG Chick. We're about done for now, anyway, with Defiance Bay. Believe it or not, we've been here forever. I just want to check really quick inside the Ducal Palace. I know our reputation is still, like, faintly mixed, eccentric. But I want to see if they'll help us regarding Adair's history. Now that we've fixed some problems here, maybe they'll take that under account. Who's the records keeper? Brother's death. The records keeper. Alright, let's see who that is. Let's slow that down because I find that kind of crazy. I know it's not her. See if she has anything more to say.
Good day, stranger.
May you be guided and tempered by the flame. It's Firga. Are you still having visions of the falls? Her voice is low and quiet. Yes, and of the cave and something within. Some small, bright ember of faith guarded by a terrible danger. I only wish I could go myself. She turns a guilty gaze on the statue. Records keeper. I don't believe he's in here. Let's just check. That's out. How long are these hearings going on? I wish to become privy to this stuff. Mr. Sears. Alright, he's up top through here, isn't he? Yep. I remember. Records keeper. That's his name. What's up, Records?
Good day to you.
Adair frowns at you and slaps his forehead. Alright, let's ask him again, even though we've asked
Hello?
Him before. The man clears his throat. We've had a number of inquiries about such information. I'm afraid we've had to bar access to the public. Seems there are still quite a number of folk in Deerwood who bear ill will towards Red Sirens. It would be irresponsible to surrender their names to just anyone. Many came to settle here as refugees. Perhaps if you were more established in Defiance Bay, things would be different, but I have no reason to suspect you to be any different from the others. Adair says, I just need to find out about my brother. I don't even know what side he fought for. You must understand, I have heard many such stories. I'm afraid there is nothing I can do for you. I want might. Probably have everyone coming down on us and attacking us. Alright, let's get out of here. Believe it or not, we're leaving Defiance Bay. I'm not even sure which quest to go on first, but... There was something involved in going back to the bridge. I don't remember what quest that was. I got quite a bunch scattered up. I forget who they were, but we found out who those people were. And I've since forgotten.
Hey, Ala, can I talk to your, your friend?
Awesome.
What is it about Isselmir? I'm right here, you know.
No, you're both great. It's just, well... I feel like I don't get to spend as much time with her, and she's just so funny. I mean, some of the things she says
are not nearly as funny when you've been hearing them for 50 years.
How old are you? I guess you are an elf. I forgot it was an elf. Figured human. Alright. Well, we need to go out some way. So. You have to look at my quest log. I've got to figure out where we're going first, right? And that's not it. Right, we've done that. I'm not sure if they're even behind this, so I don't know if I should go back to her. Travel to Deerfoot Village. Okay. That's the main quest. Anslog's Compass. That... can't do that yet. Getting to know him more. Endless Paths, doing later. Endless Paths. The Cliffs, that's when we get Sagani back. I'm not doing that yet. Cinders of Faith. Travel to that cave. Searing Falls. Oops, sorry guys. That's not happening. I can't resolve that without killing this guy, and I'm not going to do that. Not Cyril. Thristwin. I don't want to kill Thristwin, so I'm not sure how that will resolve itself. But maybe one of those quests that hang on your quest log until the end. I don't really want to deal with the Shangwilla right now. Let us gain another level or something. Winds of... oh, you know what, though? That's a good question. Anslog's Compass. And Twin Elms. You know what? That's a very good question. I forget who said it. Sorry. But we did something and got killed. And then didn't do it again. What happened? Who's this? We have an assassin. Alright. Attack the assassin. Oh! Make that assassins. Alright. We'll do this smart lick. Yeah, I figured there was just one. We're gonna rest soon. So yeah, concussive missile at this guy. If I thrust off a Palagina. Kill that one already? Canna killed assassin. Awesome. Do you knock down here? Another amplified thrust. Oh, nice! Look at that! Instant chunks. Awesome. Aloth kicking some serious butt here. Necrotic Lance on this guy. And, here she is, start hitting this guy. I'm dead. Emilio helps by doing that. Oh my god. Nice. 63 damage. Oh my god. Aloth is turning into a killing machine. on this guy.
I have them!
Go, Ayla. Finish him off.
Lava.
Kind of underwhelmed the way he just fell over instead of getting chunks again. Oh well. Can't win them all. You're doomed. Last guy's tough. Boink! Chunks. Oh my god, floating chunks. Okay, enough. Who sent these? Oh, we're gonna find out. House Domino? I mean, we're only faintly bad with them. Is anything any of this stuff special? No. Written on this scrap of parchment is a concise but detailed description of you, including your name, your distinguishing features, and everyone you've known you are known to be associated with in your brief time in Deerwood. Well, how dare they? Only I can write notes about my oh nice, novice's grimoire. About my features. Wands. Another scrawled note. Same. Oh crap, I hit take all. Oh, I hate that. Where did it go? Good question. Oh, okay, never mind. You know, not maybe this stuff all did go to the stash. So Aloth is going insane again with this crap. We need a rest before we do anything. And the only place we can rest here is at Copper Lane. Or Brackenbury, but we're not going there right now. Okay, the only obvious person, or a group of people, that would send assassins would be House Domino. Pardon me, cutting through. As you were. But is that too obvious?
Good day to you.
Mm-hmm. I like dexterity one. Vixen's Burrow. Alright. Let's be on our way. Closest one is here. So we can just run here and choose whatever district we want. I'm gonna see if we can get an edge on this Shenguilla, whatever the hell. However the hell you say that. The words in this game, the proper names of places, people and things, they're not pronounced the way you think they would. Greetings and salutations.
Eh?
Observe. When I got close enough for a good look, I noticed that the spirit seemed to be watching the horizon for something. Its hands were stained with something dark. Blood or ink, perhaps. Maybe I'll find something nearby that can help me. Now...
Sure.
I'm thinking it might be the cloak or whatever we have. Maybe I should put the cloak on? That's freaky. Stop that. Where is this cloak? Is it a quest item? Might be a quest item. Who has it? Here it is. Lilith's shawl. What if I wear it? What if I wear the cloak? She won't, like, think I'm her, right? Hold on a second. Gonna save right here. Still have to talk to what's her name outside. She might have a more answer. Whoever left the comment, thank you. I appreciate it. Unfortunately, I'm terrible with names and who tells me what. I'm not sure if you something that you know. Are you giving me a hint, or you just figured that would be a good thing to do. No, that's not it. Okay. So, we know what we know. Head back down and talk to, forget her name. Excuse me, hanging out outside. I don't think it had to be that cloak. Specifically told me to look around for something that can help me.
Good day, stranger.
Crap.
Welcome.
What do I do with you? You mean we couldn't open this? Maybe that we didn't have enough lockpicks, maybe.
I shall be discreet.
Durance, do your magic. Maybe this will help us.
I can do that. That's settled.
Could be we didn't have enough lockpicks. Jack of Wide Waters, unique light armor. Maybe if one of us wear this. Minus 20% on speed, plus 2 survival, and plus 4 damage reduction. Kakuma was a famed Omawa swashbuckler and the original wearer of this garment. She sailed from her homeland of Rarotai to the infamous Deadfire Archipelago. There she escorted merchant and passenger ships through pirate-infested waters. Among her most frequent clients were the Nasataki dwarves, who ventured to the continents to the north on both personal and tribal sojourns. Her fair dealings, bravery in combat, and skill at sea made Kakuma a loved and respected figure in the archipelago and among the Nasataki. Oh, I don't want to enchant. I don't want to click that. What if I wear that? What if I do that up? What if I wear both the cloak? I mean, I'm only thinking that, you know, these spirits are kind of not all the way there. Maybe I'll fool her into thinking I'm somebody else. Save again. It no longer says I have something to... something that will help me. Huh. I just got an addendum. I was reading through that stuff again. Okay. I know I read all that stuff. Maybe the game didn't recognize that I read it for some reason. A banshee, or what the locals refer to as a shenguilla, wails and screams from the third floor of the lighthouse. It hasn't attacked me yet, but I'll need to get rid of it one way or another before the tower is safe for Naya's workers. When I got close enough for a good look, I noticed that the spirit seemed to be watching the horizon for something. Its hands were stained with something dark, blood or ink perhaps. Maybe I'll find something nearby that can help me. The last lighthouse keeper kept a log, seemingly into the final days of the War of Defiance. This person was also tracking the appearance of a ship called the Red Dream. Naya might know more about it. Alright, let's hope that she does.
No problem.
Out with it, Missy.
Gods keep you.
So, have you figured out what all the fuss is about? Have you heard of the Red Dream? Who hasn't? That ship's been running raids for decades now. Used to stop in New Hamar, laden with spoils from Rarotai traders. These days I hear she spends most of her time prowling the Deadfire Archipelago. Naya points to a ship anchored in the distance. That's her. When she's at port, her captain, an elf named Merwith, takes her shore leave over at the Charred Barrel in Brackenbury. Believe it or not, she likes her creature comforts. She shakes her head. That's what I'm talking about. When a pirate won't even set foot in the tavern on this side of the town, it is high time for a new establishment. Alright, I guess we'll find him in the charred barrel. Meerwith. Let's go. Brackenbury. Well, we can go either way. Too bad hitting the speed up thing doesn't shorten the loading times. I know this isn't Meerwith. This is that guy that we...
Greetings.
...have to kill.
Hey.
I don't want to kill him. Yeah, that's why this won't get resolved. Because...
Eh?
I don't want to kill the guy. Who's this mayor with? Nanton? Noble? Ingroid? Abelhart Scarion? Hannah Arayakos? Victor? Noble? Noble? I am, right? Noble. 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 Be upstairs, maybe? Let's check it down here first. Cook. I know there were pirates upstairs. And bandits downstairs. Noble. Understudy. Okay, let's go upstairs. Right, wasn't she over here and she told us to scram or something? Meerwith. We would have words with thee. If I wanted company, I'd go to the salty mast. Meerwith's gold tooth catches the candlelight. What is it this time? Someone at the old lighthouse in Andra's Gift was looking for your ship. No one goes near that old place. She leans in, her voice a low hiss. If this is your idea of a setup, think again. The last lighthouse keeper watched for your ship every day. It's all in the log. No. Her snarl flashes a gold tooth. She turned me out. We were poorer than the fishermen who live there now, and when she learned I'd put food on our table with stolen coin, she told me that if she never saw me again, it'd be at the mercy of the gods. Her darkened eyes are filled with rage. I had nowhere else to go, and it was a rough life until I rose to captain. She ignored the Adair in advance to stay behind. I think she was waiting for you. She turns her eyes away. She was always so stubborn. I forget sometimes where I got it. She gulps down the rest of her wine. I'll go. Perhaps it will give both of us some peace. Yeah, then we won't have to fight these friggin' things. The Banshee shouldn't be a problem any longer. Naya's and Andra's Gift waiting for the good news. Meerwith revealed that the last lighthouse keeper, presumably the creature that haunts the upper level, was her mother. I convinced Meerwith to visit in hopes of pacifying the spirit. Captain takes a short leave with the rest of us. I love seeing the looks on those nobles' faces when we show up. Wait for these words to go away, and then nothing like a good port while at port. Huh?
Hmm.
See what you did there. Let's head back. Hey, hey. What do you say?
Gods keep you.
You'll never guess what happened. Naya points to the lighthouse. I was keeping an eye out for you, and who strolls down the deck but Meerwith herself? You should have seen the stare she got. But she walks right into the lighthouse, never a word to anyone, and just when I'm sure she's met some awful fate in there, she strolls right out, still saying nothing to nobody. Oh, I hear the clink of change. Now I'm hearing all sorts of rumors about Meerwith and the last lighthouse keeper. She shakes her head. I don't know what to believe, but everyone else around here is convinced that the place is safe again. I've even got a construction crew ready to start work. A big, contented smile on her face, and I know I've got you to thank. Here, this is for you. Come back when the renovations are done. I've got big plans for this place. Sweet. Now I can resume her renovation. And she's gone. Let me take a look inside. Oh my god! That was quick. We've got commoners. We need more reasonable people in Defiance Bay. Gotta laugh now and then, right? The sailor gives you a once-over, sizing you up. Valiant sailor. With an assertive grin, this sailor turns his face to the horizon and the sea breeze. He's inside. Terrible shame about that ship that wrecked right at the docks. Did you hear about that ship that wrecked right at the docks? Only one survivor, they say. Mind your tongue around the gift. Can't trust most folk here. It's always bittersweet sailing from home, but seeing exotic locations is a decent enough trade-off. Our ship's been dry for months. I could use a drink stiff enough to wake a dead man. If you're looking to buy exotic goods, Cartugo's right in front of the Valian Trading Company. So you talk to him. It takes a smooth tongue to solve problems, doesn't it? How do you like what I've done with the place? Yeah, that was magic. She dusts her hands on her clothing. The rooms are still under construction, but I can get you food and drink if you like. Maybe later. Times are hard. At least the Valians are still trading with us. Poultry. Just looking around. Builder. Well, they're still working up here. These days it's rare to find folks who'll do so much for strangers. I wish more people knew how to keep a cool head these days. And nothing's changed here. I believe we didn't loot this. Yeah, we left the meat. We have our work cut out for us fixing this lighthouse. Well, if we were to get a room, where the hell would it be? There are no rooms yet. Three out of three builders agree they have their work cut out for them. Well, I believe we're done with everything we have to do in Defiance Bay. Again. can see the world from out here, can we? We can. Oh, we need to go to Anslag's compass. Anslag's compass. So you've been there before, right? From Magrin's Fork. Okay, we need to go back there. I think that's what we'll do next. This is where we need to go next on the main quest. And then Twin Elms to help Palagina. I'm not sure where in Twin Elms. There's probably a whole bunch of places between here and the village in there. So... yeah. And Madmer Bridge. I forget, but we found out who those people were. I want to talk to them. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.